Even though I'm wearing this t-shirt, I'm not going to sing, so I just have to go through my stand-up routine. And since this is open mic night, no money has been paid, so if I'm not funny, then fuck you guys. So anyway, I just got back from Phuket, but last week I just got back from the election. So basically what happened was, during the elections, everyone lost. So I win. All you young kids, I know that some of you people here are first time voters. So they thought, we're going to go and vote, we're going to change the country. It didn't happen. Still same old shit. And if you don't believe me, wait 2018. G14, when PR takes over the country, it's going to be same old shit. Nothing's going to change. But little things will. For example, what happened was, after the election, everyone was talking about racism. There were talks of race riots. So what I did was, I voted in Kuantan, P84 actually, Paya Besar. So coming back to KL, what I did was, I bought two hammers, some duct tape, epoxy glue, some condoms, as well as some stabbing implements. Because if the race riot was going to happen in KL, I will go Ramsay Bolton on anyone's ass. I will do a Game of Thrones kind of shit to you guys. You know? But it's kind of sad because I didn't want to do this anymore. I didn't want to tell any more racist jokes. I thought I was done. I did that in my 20s, 30 plus years old. I thought, we're done with that, you know? But yeah, it's still there. And there are talks right now of the reconciliation thing. They want to reconcile whoever, blah, blah. I want to be on that council. I want to be on that council because I have the perfect solution for racism. It's called interracial fucking. I am the result of interracial fucking. My father's Chinese, my mother's Malay, meaning I have the best of both worlds. Right? I am greedy, like shit, I want $400 million. But I'm too lazy to do anything else. So, means it stays, keeps me away from corruption. See, so here's the thing, when you have interracial fucking, I tell you, the first is genetics. Yeah? The first why we should have it is because of genetics. I'm definitely the greatest mind of the 21st century. I look good. Every time I wake up, I go to the toilet, I see myself in the mirror, say, oh, funny stuff. And sometimes it's Benicio del Toro when my hair is a bit different. So you have people who are the result of interracial fucking are called the mixed people. And they're the best. We are the best. We are the next step in evolution. You pure blacks are the old news. You are the protons. We are the Volkswagen, whatever the fuck. But no, that's not true. You are the dinosaurs, we are the lizards, no. How does that work? But anyway. We are Homo sapiens superior. This is superior. Mixed race is the master race. Your pure blood, gone. You will be wiped out by disease. We are more resilient to disease. We're better looking. We're smarter. So you guys are all going to be killed by Homo sapiens superior. Genetics. And the thing is, once everyone is mixed in Malaysia, it means everyone's Malay. Get it? So what this does is, remember all the Malay special rights? Now since everyone's Malay, everyone has the rights. So we take out the special, now it's everyone's rights. So everyone can have the same rights as the Malays, which will all make you millionaires like me. You know? I hate to break it to you guys since after this election where, oh, we're gonna change the world! Nothing happened, but here's the truth of it. I quit my job about 70,000 times maybe in my lifetime. And every time I quit my job, I set up a company. Every time I set up a company, I always go out for drinks with some Chinese people, and they always come to me and say, easy for you lah, you Malay. I was like, every single time, they always come to me and say, easy for you lah, you Malay. I was like, What is so damn good about, if I was an UMNO Putra, maybe. So one day, I caught one of my friends who told me, easy for you lah, you Malay. And I put him, I tied him up, cross eagle, on some sort of an X cross, the Scottish cross, and I sat on a chair beside him, opposite him, and then I held on to my hammers and I said, "Let's play a game." "What do you mean when you say easy for you lah, you Malay?" And he said, "You get discounts at toll booths." I swear to God, this is true. This is true. My friend Ong Chi Yang, renowned comics illustrator, told me that he heard from friends that Malays, as part of our special rights, gets discounts at toll booths. And I said, "Okay, that's a good concept. I'm for it. But how does it work? Let's say there's like four people in the car. One Malay, three Chinese people. Or one Malay, three Indian people. Do we get a 25% discount instead of free tolls? Or is it going to be, how about this, even worse, how about this? The driver is Malay, right? And the boss is Brian Gomez, for example. So he's Indian, so the guy is Malay, so how does that work? Does he pay toll or not? So that's the kind of stuff. And then I said, "What else? What else do you want?" And which is, apa lagi cina Melayu, apa lagi cina mahu, blah, blah, blah. Right? And I said, "What else?" And he said something about, what was it? Oh, there are discounts for residential areas. "I get discounts at condominiums. I had to pay full price." He said, "Okay. How much did your apartment cost?" "600,000. Okay. How much discount do I get? About 5%, 10%. "Dude, even if they give me 90% discount, I still cannot buy because Malays are lazy. You know, we don't have money, actually. So the 5% discount actually doesn't really work. I don't own 20 houses or whatever, and I consider myself as mixed, actually. I don't really have the Malay pride. I don't care whether Hang Tuah is China or Bandung, Javanese, don't give a shit. It doesn't matter to me. What matters to me is promoting the mixed race as the master race, okay? Because, look at it this way. What's the best martial arts? Mixed martial arts, right? What's the best food? Mixed rice. Seriously, mixed rice is, you can mix it up with anything, so it means it's the best food. And what's the best feeling? Mixed feelings. You can have all the feelings in the world, like, okay, I think that's funny, but strange, I don't know. So maybe something like that. So basically, and think of all the sex as well. I mean, a dear friend, a late friend, Nasir Ahmad, she said this once. She said, "We should have sex with all the races simply because it makes us not hate that race. If you have sex with someone from another race, you will not actually hate that race. For example, I do not hate Chinese, Thai, Filipino, Indonesian, Estonian, no. Kiwis, Australians, Vietnamese, Myanmarese, Singapore, no, sorry. That was actually a Thai, so anyway. Japanese as well. So here's the thing, it is actually the answer to hate, to racism. So it should be, the opposite of hate is not love, it's actually sex. So we should all, instead of, you know, having our hangups with all the stupid shit, whatever the hell, blah, 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 we should actually just love each other physically. All right, so that's everything I prepared for today. So I'm lazy.